So, all this time we've spent together, you know, the tragedy, the brushes with death, the constant battles with the whole blight looming over us. Will you miss it once it's over? I know it might sound strange, considering we haven't known each other for very long, but I've come to care for you a great deal. I think maybe it's because we've gone through so much together. I don't know. Or maybe I'm imagining it. Maybe I'm fooling myself. Am I fooling myself? Or do you think you might ever feel the same way about me? So I fooled you, did I? Good to know. That wasn't too soon, was it? Good. I'll take that as a good sign. Make us breath, but you're beautiful. I am a lucky man. Now, let's get back to what we were up to before, lest I forget why we're here. Your desire is my command. Well, we're in camp. Now's as good a time as any to talk, right? You know, I was just thinking the same thing. Given the circumstances, things could have been so much worse. I'm so grateful that you're you, instead of some other Grey Warden. That sounded better in my head. I just mean to say that I've really come to care about you. Now we just need to be rid of that pesky archdemon and everything will be back to normal, right? Your desire is my command. Well, we're in camp. Now's as good a time as any to talk, right? Join you? In your tent? Oh, that's not it at all. Not that I want to seem overeager. I must sound like a fool. You know that I've never done anything like this with anyone. I was quite sheltered after all. I care for you so much. Whenever I think of this, I feel like a bumbling idiot, all hands. I wish I could be better at this. I want it to be right. I don't know. I'm willing to give it a shot, if you are. Right. I'm going to stop talking now. You know, according to all the sisters at the monastery, I should have been struck by lightning by now. Yep, lightning first, then the end of civilization as we know it. I'm a bad, bad man. You do realize the rest of our little party here is going to talk, right? They do that. Oh, sure, now you say that. By tomorrow, it'll be icy glares and awkward silences right before battle. Just you watch. So, what now? Where do we go from here? Right, I can handle that. I hope. Before we go, have I told you that I love you? I did. Well, it won't kill you to hear it again, will it? See? Was that so hard?
Yes.
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 Sire, I have more news.
Yes.
Well,
it seems that the fighting has gone
Enough.
Exactly as you...
I would like to know what you intend to accomplish, Father. Should we not be fighting the Darkspawn instead of each other?
The nobility should be brought into line and then the Darkspawn defeated. This is no true blight, Honora. Only Kaelin's vanity demanded it be so.
Beg pardon, sire. But blight or no, we may not have the manpower to face the Darkspawn soon.
Kaelin approached your legions for support, did he
not? Never! Marek and I drove those bastards out! Not roll out the welcome for them now!
We need help, Father. We cannot deal with this crisis alone.
Ferelden will stand on its own! I will lead it through this, Honora. You must have faith in me.
Did you kill Kaelin?
Kaelin's death was his own doing.
Rough travels out here, eh? We even saw Darkspawn on the way in. We're delivering a message to the Chantry in Denerim. You? We saw a blood mage down near the Brazilian forest. We're off to tell the Chantry about him. I thought you said... Wait. You're serious? You look pretty tough, but we just fought Darkspawn. I think we can handle a few losers in armor. Let's see what you've got.
Thank you.
And so I shall. As you desire.
but one world, one life, one death. There is but one God, and he... is our maker. They are sinners who have given their love to false gods.
What? No mention of dessert? Surely this is all.
The Mage's Collective thanks you. Make us smile upon you.
I have something for you. Some folks came in today with crazy stories about rapists. Did you hear about that?
Welcome to the wonders of Thedas. We carry...
All right. And so I shall.
All right. I guess I really don't know how to ask you this. How do I say this? You think it would be easier, but every time I'm around you, I feel as if my head's about to explode. I can't think straight. Well, I hope you mean the head-exploding thing in a good way. Here's the thing. Being near you makes me crazy. But I can't imagine being without you. Not ever. You're the first woman I've ever spent the night with. And if I have my way, you'll be the last. Good. I'm glad. Let's move on then. We've got a long way to go yet.
If there's anything I can do for you, please. I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with yours.